Alright, hey everyone, what is going on? It is Elixir here, and just gonna do a little bit of a save, and we're gonna jump straight into our objective. We've got two, hopefully mechanical pieces around. I think we will take a little bit of a long way around, just to make sure that we can pick them up before the story has us do other things. Right. Yeah, it looks like that second one is either on a different floor or inside, so let's roll up in here. Be real sneaky like. Yeah, it's not in here. So we're looking at talking to these guys. That seems like a quite nice gift, actually. If you guys would die quickly, then we can be on our merry old way. Attack on Titan music bumping me up. Let's rock and roll, boys. Alright, we got our morale boost up. And let's gain the upper hand. Okay, so one ruffian is down. We're going to avoid KnT for now, and we're going to go for the other prone ruffian, who is pretty much almost dead anyway. These guys kind of suck. Alright. We're sideways, so we're going to go for that. Boost morale. Alright, she's casting Early Bird. I'm going to go all in with this little blade skill. Okay. And you know, let's take the upper hand back. Man, they weren't kidding. That was a swift death.
So bent on killing all humans.
Who can say? Whatever the reason, this is dire news. We should let the others know ASAP. Let's call it in and head back to HQ for a full debrief.
Roger that. And here I just started to hope we'd finally escaped all this.
Escape! Yes, escape! Not to all the
I recognize that voice actor. Open that crate, man. I got two swords. What's he gonna do? Fight me? The hell? Well,
wait a minute. The beings who captured them, big brutes in armor, little pointy ears?
Yes, prone!
And they're a more recent arrival here, is that right? They're not native to this planet?
Not native, recent! If friends want more details, friends must promise to protect Tatsu. Only then will Tatsu tell.
Oh, we could just fry him.
Alma, you hold it.
Tatsu will talk! Tatsu will talk! People are native to Mira.
And then just recently the prone show up and quickly hunt you to the edge of extinction. Is that right?
Not just prone. Prone and their nasty, evil buddies. Lots and lots of them.
Their buddies? You mean other alien races?
Other hungry alien races. They all gang up on Nopon. They do horrible, terrible things to Nopon. Someday, Tatsu will turn tables and eat them for a change. Protect Tatsu. Oh, happy day. It's settled then. In return, Tatsu will accompany friends back to their village.
What do you think? Take him with us?
He seems harmless enough. And he'd be a good source of information on Mira and the Prone. All right. We can debrief him when we report to Commander Vander. As long as he passes the quarantine scan, we can bring him back to New LA.
Right. Let's get that out of the way.
Then Tatsu can join friends? Dance of joy! New friends are friendliest friends ever!
Friendliest friends ever.
Tatsu has special thank you gift for friends, for saving Tatsu's life! Tatsu will lend it to friends for free.
Lend? It's not a gift if you don't give it.
Give it away? For always? For free? This would be insulting to friends and to Tatsu.
How?
Jokes with Tatsu. Joke funny now, but joke not so funny when friend wander into Lopenville Lake on accident. Presenting Bubble Ball.
Right.
Out of
I like Lynn. She, Shots fired, back and forth. All these dancers look the same. R and X for follow ball. Right. Let's go pick up I want to take the shortcut down because I can't be bothered to fight them. Yep, everyone just did the cheeky teleport. I feel like it was a mistake. You know what? Yeah, let's fight you. You killed people. Oh, not the one I was trying to kill, but okay. Yeah, that was absolutely not what I was trying to do, but... And we are at the back, so we go for the backslash. Yeah, never reload. Just keep switching between the two if you just going for consistent damage. Close range combat is my specialty. Problem. Damn it, it was on the good side. Alright, let's team up. That was terrible, but at least we got a good on morale boost. I mean, just don't turn around. I will happily just lay into you right now. Ooh, look at all the survival gear. Ooh, that's noticeably... not helpful in any way. As cool as it looks, it really is kind of lame. Same goes for the boots. Like, they're just not that great. I've got some pretty solid equipment at the moment. Alright, so back on track. Let's bounce. Quite literally. That was awkward. We've already explored you, haven't we? I mean, I'll just run past you. If you fight me, I don't care. Yeah, they knew better. Left me alone. I love moon bouncing everywhere. It's great. Come on. No, it's still mechanic level 2, that's why it's still there. Switch to... Okay. We're at the side. Okay, that's the... Oh, You know, we are going to kill the hell out of all of these. Just to make a statement. Alright. It really is a shame we don't have Flame Grenade, because Flame Grenade was really solid against Toppling. Oh, that was a miss. Yeah, I lay right into him. You know. Places to be, people to see. I'll kill you instead. Oh, there's two of you. Actually, no, we're looking pretty good on HP. Alright, go for that, and then go around the back, and get straight in. Switch, and we're just going to keep rinsing them. Just come. Oh no, they've slowed my arts. That's kind of a pain, actually. Okay, so we need morale. Which direction are you facing? Alright, I've gone for backslash. And... well, that went south quickly. Yeah, you know, I feel like... nope. Yeah, we're out. How do you revive? Because we did it one time. We did it one time, but I don't know how we did it the other way. Oh, that's really annoying. There are a lot of vigilant enemies around here. Luckily, he is not interested in kicking our butts. Archaeological. They're like, did we just take some like whack route or something? Because like everything out here is mad strong all of a sudden. Yeah, never mind. Not jumping there. Oh, that would hurt so much. See, I didn't feel comfortable swimming through the ocean earlier on. Because it was just uncharted and it seemed like quite dangerous, but like we're so close to the base now that I think we can risk it. A level 81. See, we can't fight in the sea, so if we're gonna fight these guys, we do actually need to be on land. The morale is non-existent at the moment, so we should probably hold off on that. Where's that level 80 dude gone? Because that's the one I really want to. I don't want to fight, but I want to, you know, take a look at. Because he's kind of... The hell? Did he just despawn? He was like right in front of us. Okay, I'm really close to the next level, so I'm actually gonna go hunting. I do kind of like how the enemies kind of scale in level on the way back, because these guys were not level 10 when we last came over here. Which is good because it means you can kind of just pick them off each time you come back, just as a little bit extra experience, without having to go further and further out to go find new enemies. Everything kind of, you know, balances itself out. I don't know, did it switch to front one as soon as I was making sure I had the right art? Alright, I got it just about. Alright, nailed it. I feel like I can start selling some of that. Oh, there's one of those thingies over. Oh, it's on the other side of the cliff. But we have to head over there anyway. Do we? Where are we going? Yeah, we're going back to him. Okay, no, we can just walk around here. Alright, let's do some pathfinding. Fight me and I'll kill you. I swear to God I will do it. Oh wait, no, this is our beacon. This is the one that we put up. Silly me. Oh, we could fast travel back. What you got there, Ren? What do you mean that? Oh wait, is that, are those both for you? Jeez. Run, 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 run. I love the sprint speed. Moon bounce. Oh, it's Mars. No, I'll talk to you later. Gotta get back to the general. Oh, commander. So we'll do that, and depending how the story progresses, we will call it. We will call it there for this episode. Jump up. Oh, he's not in his little ballroom. There you are.
May be related to the forces that destroyed Earth and followed us here.
Wonderful. I'll report this to Secretary Nagi. See if we can't bolster our defenses. Just one last thing. What the bloody hell is this dancing turnip doing here?
Good question.
Tatsu, not turnip or potato. For last time, Tatsu is not food. Now, on behalf of planet Lyra, Tatsu welcome all Earth people and offer a friendly treaty of friendship.
Yeah, right. Anyway, we were thinking he could be a good source of general intel about the planet. Exactly how useful that'll be remains to be seen.
Oh, don't you worry about a thing. Friend's totally safe now that Tatsu is in town. Tatsu watch over and protect friends. Especially weak, pathetic Lindley with her thin, bony wings.
Wrecked.
Look who's talking. And who said anything about you coming with us? You can stay here, you greedy, annoying little cabbage. I'm sure there's a salad here that could use you.
Tatsu, stay here. Friends would leave Tatsu behind?
It's for the best. You said yourself your people are in danger. And the Xenos that captured you might still be out there. You'll be safest here in the city.
Agreed.
Tatsu not agreed? Friends will want Tatsu along. Friends need Tatsu along.
How so?
What? Well, that, of course. This planet have many helpful Nopon that Tatsu can talk to. Other Nopon can share information for friends.
That might be useful.
That right. Most Nopon not like Tatsu. Nopon can be shy. Nopon can be difficult. Most Nopon never trust friends or even talk to friends.
Tatsu,
Nopon love Tatsu.
Tatsu
use smooth talk and winning personality to get friends good info.
The tater tot has a point.
More like an ulterior motive, if you ask me.
Tatsu, perish the thought. Tatsu intentions are pure, Lindley. Pure as snow. Lindley intimidated by Tatsu's strength and smarts. But do not worry, Tatsu is true friend.
Strength and smarts, huh? That's really not what I'm worried about here.
Small fry here will accompany you three out in the field. After all, we can use all the info we can get.
Seriously? We have to babysit this thing?
You're the ones who picked him up.
Good point in that.
Would you really want to leave him with another team?
Maybe not. Unless we were invited to the meal, I mean.
Ooh, shots.
See? Already getting along like peas and carrots. He can be your charge.
Oh, come on, Commander! That's not funny!
How do you have your hands full?
Back me up here, would you, Elma?
I'm sure Elma has no objections.
Orcs.
Right. As you say, Commander.
Done and done. Welcome to Blade, Tater. We'll be counting on you.
That is totally what you say to potatoes. Ugh.
Why am I not surprised? So much for him watching over and protecting us.
Thank you.
So, Rook, feel like you're starting to get the hang of things?
Of course you are. You've taken to it like a fish to water, just like Elma and the commander said you would.
Just the same, let's review the key points, and I can fill in some extra details. Blade's top priority right now is to secure missing pieces of the life hold. You remember that much. Countless people are frozen in the life hold. It's the key to restoring humanity. Up until we ran into the prone, our biggest concern was that wild indigents would stumble on the life hold and damage it somehow. But now there's a more pressing threat, intelligent alien races who are intentionally trying to destroy us. So, our search has new urgency. We need to find and retrieve all of the life hold ASAP.
And the best way to do that is by expanding the reach of Frontier Nav. The more probes we can install, the wider we can scan, and the faster we can find bits of the life hold.
So our primary focus going forward should be to travel around Mira installing data probes. As many as we can, as fast as we can. I can't stress enough how important this is. You still with me? Good. Then let's move on to the other pressing threat that Blade has to deal with. Hostile indigens. There's no real delicate way to put this.
We gotta slaughter everybody.
Any wildlife that poses a clear threat must be eliminated. The life hold is our future, but we can't ignore the present. We still have our duty to keep New LA safe.
It's a good thing I'm part of the...
That duty requires an acting coordinated
Harrier? Is that what I am?
We're the newcomers here, it's true. And they're usually just out to defend their territory.
Oh, just be dicks.
But sometimes it really is them or us. And we have to make sure it's us. Don't get me wrong. It's not like we run out there and light up anything that moves. They tend to keep them strictly to creatures that pose a significant threat to our survival.
Everything.
Many as 32 members.
And it's why we ask members to sign up to a squad beforehand. We can't have Blades playing musical chairs whenever this kind of emergency hits us. But just remember, squad missions are not mandatory. You don't have to drop everything you're doing just to take one off. HQ has no way of knowing what every Blade is up to when these missions arise. If you're busy with something else, they'll understand. They need to trust our collective judgment with these things, and, well, so far so good.
And I think that about covers the basics, right?
That potato has the dumbest hair I've ever seen, even for, like, anime standards. Of course I've got all of it.
Good.
The anime and music depends on me.
And breathing adjourned. Thank God.
I like Lynn. She's funny.
Alright, well, it's getting pretty late, isn't it?
Yeah, let's call it a night.
Oh, top tired of sleeping real bad.
No, man, you're sleeping on the floor.
Lily can show Tatsu to his room now.
Oh, your room is right over there.
That's the fridge, isn't it? That was an insult. Refrigerator. I do like the name Rook. If I was aware of them calling them this, I probably would have actually called Elixir Rook simply just for the sake of it. You know, I'll see if tomorrow we can get Paulie Boy on board. Right, yeah, I'll, yeah. Multiplayer play. Want to play with friends or favorites. Well, okay, let's see what Paulie Boy is. I have no idea. Right, for now we'll do okay, so she's a reclaimer. Lynn is an outfitter. That's what I thought. Oh, sweet. Blast Fencer Plus. Alright. So we got our little team outfitted. And we are actually all good to go. We'll just do another save. And thanks again for watching, guys. If you liked this episode, then be sure to leave a like, drop us a comment on what you'd like to see us do in the next episode, because we'll probably, unless we're forced into story missions, probably do a couple of side quests, you know, get to know our new barrack members. But yeah, if you'd like to see me do anything differently, let me know in the comment section and subscribe to catch us in the next episode as soon as it comes out. All right, guys, peace.